So I signed Van Halen a long time ago, 1977, and produced their first 24-track demo and all that. And some of the songs, most of the songs you hear on the first record, Van Halen record, and some of the second ones, they were all done together. They re-recorded them, but a lot of it. When we came back from Japan, I let the band go. I said, "You're free to go." The Kiss guys didn't hear it. They didn't think they were special. So I wanted to take them out on tour, but they just didn't hear. And so when I came back to LA, I had written three new songs. That became Got Love for Sale, and also this one. Seen another one, but when I got back to LA, I wanted to do demos of them. And I called up the Van Halen brothers, and God bless them, they came out in the middle of the night, like 1 o'clock in the morning. We went to the studio as a trio, and we cut this song. Let me let you hear it from the beginning a little bit. This is me on keyboards, and all the background vocals, a little rhythm guitar, a little bass, but it's Edward, he likes to be called Edward, Edward and Alex, together, this is what a trio would sound like if Van Halen and Gene Simmons got together. Okay, boss. So the solo that Eddie played on that was so good that I forced Ace, he hated that solo, but I forced him to copy that solo note for note. And then it became a hit song.
That song came from you making fun of Paul Stanley.
Paul and I always make fun of each other because he wishes he was me and... Oh, sorry, I didn't... We're like brothers, and you know, like brothers, you always have fun times and make fun of each other. And so we got to arguing one day and about something stupid. Oh, you only write, Paul said, you know, but can't you write something else? You always write, you know, these monster songs. I'm saying, no, I'm writing man songs, men, you know, music that men sing, you know. My love is all so bad. You're not the only one I've ever had. You know, men. And Paul writes girl songs. You know, so, but really good song that he's done. Put your hands on my rocket. See, that's good. Put your hands on my rocket.
I know a rocket.
And put your hands on my rocket. That's cool. Lucille, what's my part?
Take me!
Paul. Put your hands on my rocket. Grab the fucking rocket. That's good. What's my part?
Take me!
Don't you want me to say it?
Me.
And what's take me? We're men. I'm gonna take you. Take you. Break you.
Because I got the.
No. Your part is
take me. Break me.
No girl's ever broken. I break you.
Break me.
So we've been doing that song for a long time, here and there, here and there. And then Paul comes in with a great song, really good. Tonight, could be a Broadway song. I want to kneel alone, whatever the words are. Yeah, in the darkness, which became a huge hit. What's my part? Paul, can't I sing this like? Find where you live and I'm gonna crawl in bed. Oh, no, your part is. And on stage, I'm spitting fire and flick and look, you know, I feel really strong. And then, okay, how y'all doing? Here's the next song. We still do that song today. We can play to a state. We're doing Spain in July, Kiss, and a big 100-city worldwide tour in 2019. 150, actually. And there'll be outdoor shows, and people are jumping up and down like grasshoppers, and entire stadiums of people. And I'm doing that, even to this day. Sorry.
That's it.
Okay, well.
No, so let's talk about the vault a little bit, and then I'll open it up to questions. Because people, you know, people have, maybe they don't know what's inside, they don't know what they're going to get. There's one guy who's been, well, you tell him a little bit, and there's one guy who's emailed me 100 times, doesn't actually believe there's gifts in the vault. So.
Okay, this is, you know what American bowling balls are, right? Right? They're round and they weigh about 10 pounds. I know you have centimeters and sticks, I don't know. So, but they're heavy. So that weighs as much as 4 bowling balls, 40 pounds. Yeah, that's heavy, because it's meant to last a generation. And when I'm going to hand you your vault, because I promised you I would, we're going to have a good-looking American over here who's going to pick it up for you so that you don't hurt your back. Inside, and there's metal pieces, metal wheels, inside, 50-year history of music from 1966 to 2016. A huge book with 50,000 words that I wrote, containing 11 CDs, 167 songs. If you started playing it and didn't go to the bathroom, it would be over 10 hours straight of music that had never been released. And there's a Gene Simmons action figure and a gold coin. Oh, you're gonna do it. And that's how you open it, you pull it. You can throw my coat on the floor, it's okay. I don't care.
Sure.
And the big book is heavy, you need two hands. And the Gene Simmons action figure, very good looking. And a gold coin that says, if it's too loud, you're too old, in Latin. That's a collector's item. And because I always want to give something back because you made my life special, there's a secret door at the bottom. And when you push it, it opens up, and every single box set is different. You're going to get a gift from my collection, and once you get, not you, but you, once you get the gift, I won't have it in my collection, you understand? So these are one-of-a-kind collector's items. Most of the time, it's more than one piece. It could be shades, it could be my old wallet, it could be pieces of my dragon boot, it could be anything. It could be old lyrics, all kinds of stuff.
So I'm going to bring up this guy, Daniel. Daniel, come up. Daniel's been emailing me. Bring your lady friend up here as well. He's saying, I don't think there's really that cool stuff in the vault. So Daniel, you guys, come up here on the side. I'll prove you all.
Wow!
it's like this.
Swedish.
Yeah. Det tog 30 år för Jim att feja till kärnorna. Och jag växte upp i Jims skola och tyckte liksom, nej, Jim tror inte på äktenskap. Då tror inte jag på äktenskap. Men jag har varit ihop i 15 år här och jag har pratat lite om det. Och tyckte, nej. Men 2012 fick jag höra att nu har Jim gift sig med kärnan.
Ja,
bra. När ska vi gifta er? Ja. Och nu kom tillfället och...
What a perfect moment.
Ja, inför Jim.
I understand.
For you, Jim. So, Carrie, Kattis, will you marry me?
Yes, of course.
Other balls, just so you know.
Did you plan that? I helped a little bit.
Wow. So let's open it up to questions if you'd like. Get some questions. Eric over here, if you have a question, raise your hand. I'll try and come towards you and ask some questions.
Questions?
Eric.
Please turn the microphone on.
Hello, hi Jean, it's very nice meeting you.
Quickly who?
I'm so lucky to be here today because I wasn't supposed to be here really, because I was scammed. I got a tweet from somebody who claims to be you, and I believed in him.
Oh, I saw that. Yes,
yeah, and I paid $1,500, okay? And he said, I can't afford it. And he said, how much can you pay? I'm sorry, but $1,500, that's my stretch. I can't pay anything more. And then outside, I took my chances. I met Keith, and he was nice enough to give me this wristband so I can see the show. But I want to, you know, get the vault and all the other stuff. But I appreciate so much to be here. So my question to you is, if it's okay by the audience, if I can go up on stage, sit next to you by a guitar and take a picture.
Sure.
Is that okay?
Of course.
Oh, great.
Can I get you a sandwich or give you a back rub? Come and sit down. Play guitar?
No.
You have to stop doing that.
You can play.
He always wanted to direct.
Question about
that. Yeah, thanks. Give him a big hand, maybe that'll get him.
About 50 years of your career, And of course I'm interested in hearing you talking about what parts you're the most proud of and what parts you're less proud of during those 50 years.
I didn't like the 80s so much. I thought the bands started to look exactly alike, you know. I really liked Bon Jovi, but then there was Warrant and 100 other bands, and a lot of bands. But my favorite is...
what's that? Aha, uh-huh,
Take on Me.
Huh?
Aha, uh-huh, Take on Me.
Especially this part. Take on me, take me home.
No, I think he was asking what part of your career in the 50 years.
I know, but I went off on
that. Oh, you're in a tangent. You did. It's my job to bring you back.
You know, no matter how many girlfriends you're going to have and who's you're going to kiss and do anything to, that first kiss and that first girlfriend is going to be with you for the rest of your life. And for me, it was writing that first stupid song that I wrote, My Uncle is a Raft. I'll never forget that, because it's those things in life that are the first that when you look back on it, you know, it means something here. Not, you can do something better, but the emotion that's tied in it, because music is just a soundtrack, like a movie to your life, right? Not just these songs, but if you go to a funeral, there's music. If you pledge allegiance to the Swedish flag, there's music, you know? So you get married to music, everything is about music. And I think the first time, you know, when you get married, people have their favorite song. Are you married? Do you want to get married? Trust me, when and if you get married, she's going to decide what you're going to do. Which song and all that. So, My Uncle is a Raft.
Questions? Anyone else? Question right there.
Gene, could you tell me the story about Stanley the Parrot and why isn't it on the box set?
Yeah, why isn't it on the box?
Well, there are other songs, but there's just... I wanted to copy The Who. So stupid. When Tommy came by, so I came up with chords that I liked. And they were solo, and I played all the parts. And then it went into Stanley the Parrot regards himself as less than a man. He still regrets it. Even now we don't remember Stanley is the time for summer is the time for making them. Stanley doesn't think he can. He now regards himself as quite a man. And so when Paul heard that, he said, are you out of your fucking mind? Stanley the Parrot? What's that? But these are good chords. So he took them and he went. And Paul thinks he wrote Strutter, but I think I did. Those are my chords, and then I added. He thinks he wrote the. Yeah, he probably did. Probably wrote the lyrics. I think that's him. Strutter. He thinks Strutter's his style. I think it's mine. Yeah, but he probably wrote it. That's the story of Stanley the Parrot. So, you know, I still have some of that material. Is Lita on the box set?
Yeah. Lita is, yes.
Da-da-da-da. school.
Date. Girl you used to date in school.
Date.
Date.
Hey, Jamie.
Where?
Here.
Right there.
They were getting this. Talking about this old song, I want to ask you, do you have some other songs from the bands before, talking about Bullfrog Beer and Wicked Lester?
Bullfrog Beer, yeah.
Yes.
This song. Moving on, moving on. That's from Bullfrog Beer, before Wicked Lester, before Kiss.
1969?
1869.
Yes.
It's a bad joke. 1969, yes.
Yeah.
Bullfrog Beer. And we used to do this in Bullfrog. And we used to
do Wicked Lester.
Then Wicked Lester did it again. And Little Lady, which is also on the box set, Bullfrog Beer used to do. And then I recorded a demo. Wicked Lester didn't do it, but then Kiss did. Did that answer the question? Good.
The question was, do we have any chance in the future to get some more old, obscure songs from that year?
Yes.
Thank you.
And there's going to be a Kiss Monster box set at some point when we have time. Because I kept all the tapes. I collect everything that's about me, but I collect it. So there were lots of songs. Paul did lots of demos, so did Ace and Peter, that they thought are lost. I've got them. Yes, sir.
Hi, Jim. I have a question. I'm really fond of the album you produced for Duropech in 1990. And you have a lot of...
Duropech?
Yeah, the album you produced for her. And you have a lot of co-writes on that. If you remember, are those leftover tracks from Who Didn't End Up on Hot in the Shade? And why weren't they included on Hot in the Shade? Why got rejected? In my opinion, a lot of tracks on Doro's album you wrote are much better than some songs on Hot in the Shade. Like Read My Body, for example.
You know, I agree with you, but when you do something, you don't always see clearly, and sometimes somebody who's there can say, you know, I don't like this, I like that's better. And go, really, that's better? Yeah, so you don't know it, but this one. I got a reputation, people know who I am. That one, I wrote for Wendy, Wendy O. Williams. It's my life. Anyway, I forgot the chords. And so It's My Life was written about Wendy O. Williams, who, you know, didn't really play the fame game. I got a reputation, people know who I am. Rules are made to be broken. So I tried to write a few songs that Kiss wouldn't do. And some of them, you know, wound up on the box set. This one.
Accidentally wrote Stairway to Heaven, a song you thought.
So I heard a group called the Bee Gees before they sang like that. They used to sing harmonies, Beatlesque things. And their first hit was called New York Mining Disaster, 1942 or 1949? 1942. Two.
No, it's 1949.
1949.
It's one of those two.
One of them. And I love that chord. It's really an A minor chord. It's like this. But the way they did it is this. It just sounds so moving. And they went, in the event of something happening to me, there is something I would like. So they did that song. And I took that chord, and you know, I like that. Maybe if I pick it. Gee, that sounds really good. Oh yeah, I think I got something. What now? That's good. I started to write Stairway to Heaven.
Years after Stairway to Heaven already existed.
Yeah, I started to write it. I got this far. I didn't know. But you know, lots of songs are like that. You know this one?
Here in the back, I've always been a bit curious about what album will Kiss that you're most proud of as a whole. You know, I mean, it's good songs and maybe less good songs on every record, maybe, but as a whole album, which are your most proudest moment?
It's really tough, you know. You know, a mother who has 10 kids. It's difficult to answer, you know, who's your favorite child? It's tough. Although I know she said you. The first album may not be the best record, not recorded well. It has some technical problems. But I think it's the most honest record. We didn't know how to tune guitars. We just did. We didn't know about this. Kind of harmonic. We didn't know how to tune. We just went. And we also knew this. We didn't know about machines that helped you tune. We didn't know about anything. We just did what we wanted to do. I ripped off a song. It's a song called Bitch by, it's actually Paul's favorite song. Just, it's a song by the Stones. It's a bitch, and then Jagger says that. So I ripped that off. And that's where Deuce came from. Deuce came from a version of Bitch by the Stones. And so we were all busy writing our own songs, and Black Diamond was actually written for Wicked Lester. We didn't have enough songs, but whatever songs we had, Strutter used to be Stanley the Parrot. And so maybe the first record